good, bro?
Coming up is going to be a special Passover service. Right afterwards, we will be having our free barbecue. So go ahead and make sure you come out for that. Let's pray. Father God, thank you for your presence here tonight. We love you and we worship you. We cannot wait to bless you with our worship, and we open our hearts to hear you speak to us through this sermon. In Jesus' name.
Amen. We have an open altar. You're free to come up and worship your King.
Well, I searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. A man's empty praise and treasures the faith are never enough. You came along and put me back together, and every desire is now satisfied here in your love. Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you. There's nothing is better than you.
And I'm not afraid to show you my weakness, my failures and flaws. Look, you've seen them all, and you still call me friend. God of the mountains, is the God of the valleys, and there's not a place your mercy and grace will find me again.
Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing. Nothing is better than you.
Oh, there's nothing.
There's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you. There's nothing. Nothing is better than you.
Turn morning to dancing. You give beauty for ashes. You turn shame into glory. You're the only one. Morning to dancing.
You turn morning to dancing. You give beauty for ashes. You turn shame into glory. You're the only one who
can.
You turn graves into gardens. You turn bones into armies. mountain, season to highway. You're the only one who can.
Praise into garden.
You turn graves into gardens. You turn bones into armies. You turn seas into highways. You're the only one who can. You're the only one who can. You're the only one who can.
Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing.
Your fire fall again. It's burning. soul, burning in my soul, burning in my soul, burning in my soul. I cannot contain it, this fire inside. Contain it, so let it shine. I cannot contain it. This light of mine is burning in my soul. Hear the sound from heaven. Whoa, a mighty rushing wind. Whoa, we're calling for revival. God, let your fire fall again. It's burning in my soul, burning in my soul, it's burning in my soul, it's burning in my soul.
Has broken chains off of you, that he has set you free. The scripture says that he who is free indeed. Hallelujah. If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice tell the same old lies, if you're trying to fill the same old holes inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, save it. He's a prison shaking savior. You got chains. He's a chain breaker. We're gonna do one. If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice tell the same old lies, if you're trying to fill the same old holes inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker.
We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. We've all run to things we know that just ain't right. When there's a better life, better life.
If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, He's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, He's a prison shaking savior. And He got chains, He's a chain breaker.
Anybody need to testify?
If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify, testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you got pain, He's a pain taker. If you feel lost, He's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, He's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, He's a chain breaker. If you got pain, He's a pain taker. If you feel lost, He's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, He's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, He's a chain breaker. Somebody testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify, testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you got pain, He's a pain taker. If you feel lost, He's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, He's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, He's a chain breaker. If you got pain, He's a pain taker. If you feel lost, He's a way maker. If you need freedom, saving, He's a prison shaking savior. You got chains, He's a chain breaker.
But I'm celebrating the resurrection. Ain't no grave gonna hold me down. Ain't no grave hold my Jesus down.
Oh, shame is a prison as cruel as a grave. Shame is a robber, and he's come to take my name. Oh, love is my redeemer, lifting me up from the ground. Love is the power where my freedom song is found. There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. There ain't no sound, I'm gonna rise up out of the ground. There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. Whoa, When I hear that trumpet sound, I'm gonna rise up out of the ground. There ain't no
out of the grave, I'm walking to the grave.
If you walked out of the grave, I'll walk into
no more dead things.
If you walked out of the grave, I'll walk into
life.
If you walked out of the grave, I'll walk into. If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to.
Go on, sing it.
If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to.
Come on, Jesse, come on.
If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to. I'm walking to.
Come on.
If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to.
Yeah, yeah.
If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to.
Got my strut.
If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to.
I'm stepping high.
If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to.
I'm stepping high.
If you walked out of the grave, I'ma walk into
no more pain.
If you walked out of the grave, I'ma walk into
no more anger.
If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walked out of the grave, I'ma walk into.
Come on, walk.
If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to.
Come on.
If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walked out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to.
You gotta walk.
If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to. If you walk out of the grave, I'm walking to.
There ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. Glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Ha! Woo, okay.
Come on, let's just give them a little more praise tonight. Yo, radical, man. I go to a radical church. I love that. Well, yeah, come on. Jesus, somebody. Hey, somebody. Woo, bunch of radicals. Y'all can sit for a minute. we'll get down here again in a minute. You know what I'm saying? What's up, buddy? So many good people that I seen that I invited, and my family's here, and I'm blessed by that. Yeah. My cousins, my little cousins, they all be up out here, out her. Oh, Belinda, it's your turn. You're up. Yeah, give her a hand. Come on. Come on. She's going to give us the teaching text tonight. So go ahead.
Can you guys hear me? No? Now? Okay. Okay. I'm going to be reading John 8, 1 through 11. And it says, Jesus returned to the Mount of the Olives, but early the next morning he was back again at the temple. A crowd soon gathered, and he sat down and taught them. Can you guys hear me? Okay, just making sure. As he was speaking, the teachers of religious law and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in the act of adultery. They put her in front of the crowd. Teacher, they said to Jesus, this woman who was caught in the act of adultery. Oh, yeah. The law of Moses says to stone her. What do you say? They were trying to trap him into saying something they could use against him, but Jesus stooped down and wrote in the dust with his finger. They kept demanding an answer, so he stood up again and said, all right, but let the one who has never sinned throw the first stone. Then he stooped down again and wrote in the dust. When the accusers heard this, they slipped away one by one, beginning with the oldest, until only Jesus was left in the middle of the crowd with the woman. Then Jesus stood up again and said to the woman, where are your accusers? Didn't even one of them condemn you? No, Lord, she said. And Jesus said, neither do I. Go and sin no more.
Thank you. Give her a hand. Woo! Yeah. So we just started this series, Jesus Stories. We've had some beautiful sermon series, you know, leading up to this, even on Sunday. So basically, you know, Pastor Philip kicked it off last week. But we want to go through the Gospels and different accounts where he actually, like, talked to people. So that's what this series is about, Jesus Stories. So we're just going to read through this line by line, and then I have a demonstration for you, and those of you who I ask you to help, and those who I'm just going to call on the spot can help me. So let's just start with verse 1. Jesus returned to the Mount of Olives, but early the next morning, somebody say early. He was back again at the temple. See, already I think we can learn something from this. He returned from the mount. Most likely, you know, the day before, he already taught all day. He already ministered all day. He was doing the work. Can somebody relate? They busy. They're doing the stuff. And then not only that, he doesn't go stay inside of the town. He goes out of the town and stays there. But yet, even though there was distance, tire, weariness, whatever it may be, it says he still came back early. You see, I believe Jesus was diligent to do the work set before him, right? So that's something we can learn right there. We need to be diligent to do the work the Lord set before us. Amen. A crowd soon gathered, and he sat down and taught them. As he was speaking, the teachers of the religious law and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in the act of adultery. They put her in front of the crowd. So that right there, we see, as he was speaking, what happened? Basically, they interrupted him. As he was speaking, they interrupted him. As if right now, somebody burst through those doors, dragging a woman, and start asking me this. This is the setup. And they put her in front of the crowd. See, they did this for a reason. They were trying to get people against him. They wanted it to be public. Teacher, they said to Jesus, this woman was caught in the act of adultery. Yes, caught. He was caught. So as I was studying about this for this message, that really stuck out to me. This lady was guilty.
There was no sense for a trial because they caught her in the act. She was guilty. It wasn't just an accusation. It was reality. Then in verse 5, the law of Moses says to stone her. What do you say? See, this question is provoking, right? It's provoking because if he said, go ahead and stone her, then they probably would have brought Jesus before the Romans, because the Romans didn't allow the Jews to execute by death, right? So in that way, it's a slippery question. They're tricking him. They're trying to trick him. But if he pardons her, then they may have claimed he was a false prophet. They might have said, you're against the law. You're against the religious law. So herein lies the trick. Verse 6, they were trying to trap him into saying something they could use against him. But Jesus stooped down and wrote in the dust with his finger. Now, it doesn't say what he was writing. And this is Pastor Brad, but I think it can speak to us. Maybe in the middle of adversity, of struggle, of decision, where it's like, either way I look, it looks wrong. Right? Maybe he was just slow to speak. Maybe in my mind, I'm like, maybe he said a quick prayer. Maybe he's like, Father, what do I do? What do I say? Right? Because we know he says, I only do what I see and hear the Father doing, right? Verse 7, they kept demanding an answer. So he stooped down again and said, all right, but let one who has never sinned throw the first stone. Now for us, just think about that stone. This is like for us today, it's still condemning somebody. That's literally what they were going to do. We've talked about this a little bit before, but condemning is like sentencing somebody. Conviction is you're trying to convince them of the error. There's a difference in those two words. But in this case, literally, they're trying to carry out the orders, you know? But let's talk about, but then he catches them. He puts it back on them by saying, well, let he who's never sinned, right? He didn't say, he who doesn't have sexual sin cast the first stone. No, he didn't say that. No. But the wages of sin is death. There's already a sentence there, right? So I think in their minds in that time, they were like, ooh, this lady's a sexual sinner. Let's get her. That's nothing compared. They almost don't feel like what they have going on is nothing compared to that, right? That's what equips them to hold that stone. Then he stooped again, down again and wrote in the dust. When the accusers heard this, they slipped away one by one, beginning with the oldest, until only Jesus was left in the middle of the crowd with the woman. Then Jesus stood up again and said to the woman, where are your accusers? Didn't even one of them condemn you? Condemn you. Right, going back to that condemning versus conviction. How would this have story played out if they were like really whole and like serving the Lord Jesus? I think they would have been there, not interrupting the service, not interrupting the teacher. They would have said, hey, lady, hey, woman, come with me. You got to meet a man. Right? You got to meet a man. You got to meet this Holy Spirit that brings conviction, right? The Holy Spirit tells us when we're doing something wrong, right? Verse 11, no, Lord, she said. And Jesus said, neither do I. The one who could say without sin, neither do I. You see, this lady that looked probably like one of the worst in this time, encounters Jesus with this incredible love, and he literally encounters his mercy. We've talked about this a little bit. Mercy. Because mercy is when you don't get what you deserve. This, according to the religious law, right? That was the sentence. But Jesus said, neither do I. Mercy. His mercy. Go and sin no more. And you know what, guys? I believe that she did that, at least in that area of her life. Because I believe when you encounter, when you have that loving encounter with Jesus, and he gives you his mercy, it changes that thing inside that made me want that to begin with. That's what a love encounter with the mercy of Jesus does. And I was just kind of like in that, also reflecting on Romans 5 and 6. And it's like, as the people sinned more and more, God's wonderful grace became more abundant. Right? But then he poses a question. So then should we all just go ahead and keep on sinning so that his grace would abound more and more? Of course not, he says. Of course not, right? But it really doesn't matter, because when you have that love encounter with the mercy of Jesus, and I'm going to talk about this a little more as we get towards the closing, but actually, if you could go ahead and come up, and actually, Gaio, too, can you help me? Can you guys come up and help me? Yeah, give him a hand. We can move this, actually. I'm done with it. Oh, yeah, perfect. Perfect. All right, I brought you up for your muscles to help me out. You brought the perfect shirt, bro. All right, can you go grab that bucket for me and bring it over here? Yeah, bring the bucket. Bring the bucket. Pastor Philip got me this. Nice bucket of stones, right? Right? So, I'm going to hand this to you. Right? Hand it. Take it. Right? So, you're a little impaired now, right? You can't use that hand. Right? So, whatever task, whatever work you have to do with one hand now, right? All right. What if I give you this one and this hand? Now you're really pretty impaired, right? But you can still kind of walk around, right? Yeah. So you can do some of the work set before you, right? Bring me one of those. Just one, then bring the next one. What about this one, buddy? Yeah, bring it. You can kind of do your work. You can kind of walk around a little bit. A little bit. Yeah, but what happens when I hold on to another one? What happens if you hold on to another one? Now can you still walk around a little bit? Barely? Starting to get hard to do the work set before you, isn't it? How you doing now, buddy? It's hard to walk, huh? Oh, yeah. It's now it's hard. Now you can't even do anything. You can't do any of the work set before you, right? Right. All right, buddy. I'm sorry. I'm done picking on you. You guys can. Yeah, you can put it back over there. Give him a hand. Are you guys understanding the example? When I was getting ready for this, you guys can sit too when you're done. When I was getting ready for this, I felt the Lord saying, there's going to be people. You guys can sit. Thank you. Give him a hand. There's going to be some people who need to let some people go. Maybe you got the one rock. Maybe you got the bucket. Maybe you got the blocks. You can't even do the work set before you anymore. But I would encourage you tonight, even if you only have the one stone, just let it go. Just let it go.
If you could start playing that, that'd be great. Just let it go. And then the other person, I want to talk about the woman a little bit. I always like to ask myself, give myself a little more maybe perspective on these stories, but I'm like, who was this woman, right? You know, maybe it was her marriage that drove her to it, whatever. Or maybe it was trauma before that, maybe in her upbringing, maybe her dad wasn't available, maybe her dad was gone, maybe her dad was absent. And there was just this hurt and this hole in her heart, and she had to find, she was trying to fill it with the men, right? Right? But I totally believe, the worship team can come too, but I totally believe she had this encounter with the love in Jesus that showed her mercy. It didn't show her condemnation, it showed her mercy. And I really believe it changed her whole life. It changed her whole life. So maybe that person relates to you too. I'm going to leave these buckets up here, guys. It's what happens in your heart. It doesn't matter if you use these. But some of you need to get up here and start dropping these stones down. Let's all stand. Father, we give you thanks. You can feel free to pray. You don't have to. I know you're being polite, but you guys can pray on your own too. We give you so much thanks, Jesus, for your loving kindness, that you offer mercy, that you didn't come into this world to condemn it, but to save it. Would you save us tonight? Would you save us tonight? Would you allow us? Would you touch hearts right now, Holy Spirit, that they would let those stones go, they would let those bricks go, that they would let you heal their heart from the place that's keeping them bound. We love you. You're worthy. You're worthy. We're going to sing this song. But either way, don't wait on me. Don't wait on me to call you up. This is not my moment. This is your moment. You need to let people go. You get up here and start letting people go.
I surrender.
seeing grace unfold. I hunger and thirst. I hunger and thirst. Arms stretched wide, I know you hear my cry. Speak to me now. Speak to me now.
Surrender. There is
is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me.
Oh, yeah, we're already over time. Come on, yeah, give them a praise. I will stay and worship with y'all some, but if you have kids, make sure you go get your kids. We're just going to stay kind of in this moment a little bit. I hope at the end of the day you were actually encouraged. I know that was kind of a bomb, and I'm sorry, but I see a lot of rocks up here, and can we just give the Lord a hand for that? Yeah. Amen. God bless you guys.
There is no one like you.